mighty name, amen, amen, and amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You feel me this way. I don't know. He stands by his word all the time. His covenant stands on the children of Israel till today. That they will be the head and they will never be the tail.
And that covenant is still to stand to your church till this moment. I bring you into the covenant of God. The covenant that uplifts a person that the enemy cannot throw you down. In the name of Jesus, I'm speaking to you, brother and sister. I want to say a resounding amen. Three amen. The covenant uplifts that the enemy will bring you down. Yes. 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 Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
It's the scripture reads, ask and ye shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and it shall be opened. Because he that asks receives. And he that seeketh. And he that knocketh. The door will be open unto him or her. Let's read it again. Ask and it shall be given. Seek.
And you see,
and ye shall find. Knock. And it shall be open. Everyone that asks receives.
And it's open water.
And he that seeketh,
and it's open seeker.
Find it. And he that knocketh shall be open.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You born well. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Lift up your eyes and focus on the Lord. Last,
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Why are you, frowning your face? You shouldn't be frowning your face to the Most High God. You're supposed to be able to laugh unto God. Lift up your face so that the heavenly host can take a selfie of you and can take it to the heavenly host. Now look at this wonderful image of me. I want to give you another glory.
Praise the Lord!
The Aki photo is here, he can even get you a good photo.
So, food here, but you are so capable of thinking,
laugh, God wants to give you something to
Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah! Oh, yes, somebody is burning their face. Ah. Elder, I am thinking, you are pointing your face.
Oh, you thinking, right?
Why are you pointing your face?
Yeah, baby, you're running your corner, you're running your corner. I'm running your seat, that's Christ.
Praise the Lord!
You see the friend,
I'm running so many among you.
Oh, you're running here.
As you are laughing,
but you are late to come in, buddy.
I pray as this year.
Oh, maybe, but
what's that?
It's a big word. Ask.
And it will not be.
He that ask wants an answer.
He down will make it call.
The answer to building a house.
Oh, the law may be the law of pilot.
You can't ask from the pilot how to build a house. Because that is not his line of preference. His line of duty is how to fly a plane. And to fly that plane, that will transport people to their destination. Now, when you have questions about building a house, the expert about building a house, I'm talking about the builder.
prayer.
You need to direct your questions to the builder.
Prayer, I hope you fly.
The Bible says, ask, it shall be given to you.
When
you ask from the right person, then you get the right answer. Even ask from a novice. The answer you will get will be a mediocre answer. Because you are not asking the right
question. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah. Please, when you are saying hallelujah, look up to the heavens and say that hallelujah. Because God wants to see your beauty and your glory. You can't be looking down and the camera is up here from the heavenly
host.
And they want to manifest glory in your life. Some people, their laugh is, please laugh majestically.
Praise the Lord.
Many are asking from where they are not supposed to be asking. Ask and it shall be given unto you. What is the modality of being given to you? How will it be given to you when you are not standing upright in front of the Lord? How would you be answered in terms of giving you the right answer at the time you and I are asking, when we are not even steadfast in Him? God is not foolish, and God is not a push and start. To whenever you are zealous about answers, you want those answers to come. Some people want to use the particular to get it from God. And at the time they're supposed to perform in terms of acting towards God, they didn't ask towards God. The time they are supposed to be there sacrificing, they are not sacrificing. When they are supposed to help many people in the congregation and help people, when they are supposed to use their glory and their life to glorify God, but it is only when people are in problems they know God. Hallelujah. Many when they are afflicted, they remember God. They remember affliction. Many they have affliction. That's when they turn to God and ask Him from God. Ask, it shall be given. Now the question is, will He give it to you truly? When you ask at the right appointed time, will He truly give it to you? But are you not asking only when you are in problems? Will He give it to you? Is the reason why you are calling to God not, is it not because you are in problems right now? Ask, it shall be given, is what the scripture says. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Of all what you ask of Him, you and me, all of us are before God. I pray for you what you
know for Jesus, for your
faithful.
Ask,
it shall be given. Seek, and you will be found.
Many of our Christians,
Some Christians are lazy. They are praying. They are fasting. But to seek. To take the step. They don't take any step. God is not a magician. God is going for abracadabra. You have prayed to God truly. You have asked. He has sent a message to you. That he has answered you. But you have not taken that step. I have not taken that step. Have we taken those steps? Ask, it shall be given. Seek. That is, look for it everywhere.
You see,
and you will find it. Is what the Bible says. Now, the next step after asking is not just staying there; it's moving on. There was another step. Was looking for something. Knocking was another thing. Knocking.
How is it? Is it left for you?
It shall be open.
It's only a little bit. The Lord is
someone that asks me. If you don't ask, you cannot receive. If you can't find, you can't see. If you knock, they will help you. Because he that knocks, he that asks, receive. He that seeks, will find. And he that knocks, the door will be opened. Who is that man among you? And they have everlasting problems or cry or sorrow.
Okay, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Our men, can we repeat that voice?
Okay, hallelujah.
Ask. It will be given unto you, master. When you stand firmly, and I'm standing before the Lord of Christ, when we ask, He will then give us. At the time we are asking, Abraham stood before God. He said, God, you have made all the promises. And you are actually fulfilling this promise. But there's one more thing you have not fulfilled. You have not fulfilled that. You said, I will have wealth. I have wealth. I have money. I have many men working on that.
And
where is that promise child?
Hallelujah.
Just look up. Count all the stars. He was asking from his maker about the covenant of God for his life. He was asking God as regards the promise God had made for him. He was asking the Lord. He didn't ask from another God. He asked his creator that can uphold the promises he has made. Where is the promised child you said you will give to me? And God now took him into another covenant. Eventually, the promise came to pass because he kept steadfastly asking from God. Please don't allow somebody who is godless to describe God to you. Stand with that God you are calling upon. Because when he, after a while you're calling him, one day he will answer you. Bartholomew, the blind man, he called unto Jesus. He knows about the power of Jesus. He knows Jesus can open his eyes. But his inability or disability prevents him from doing anything. He is not free to walk to Jesus. He is not like the woman with a pressure of blood. She is not blind. She can see Jesus. She can run to move to touch the garment of Jesus. Bartholomew, don't forget, he was blind. He had called upon many people to take him to Jesus. They ignored him. But there was a day he was passing by in Jericho. He was asking people. Now, this is what bewilders me. Jesus knew he was blind. And when Jesus got to him, Jesus now asked somebody who is blind another question. What do you want me to do for you, blind man? Now, the question is, many people truly come to the house of God, but they don't even know what they want from God. Some people come to the house of God, they are just eavesdroppers. They are hearing what other people are saying. They are not even particular about their life. Some people come truly to the church. They are coming to act as spectators to your testimony. Because my testimony, your testimony is coming this year. They will be spectators. They are spectators. I pray for you. My sight. That day, blindness led the life of Bartholomew. Are you going to hear the truth this morning? Many Christians are blind spiritually. And they are not ready to regain their spiritual sight. They are not ready to regain that sight spiritually. I'm talking about Christians who are blind. And many of them, they are not even ready to question their destiny. Sir? Now, the question about their destiny, that God is asking them, the answer they are giving the heavenly ones is not even matching anything. Because they don't know what they're doing. The Bible says, ask, it shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and it shall be opened. Look at, examine your life. Since you became a believer, are you steadfast in it? As he accomplished the covenant in your life, examine your vicinity. Who are your mates? Who are you talking to? When you are moving with them, examine your life. Are you moving from the world? Or you are drawing away from God? If you look at your life and you see your friends, the people you are talking to, as you are moving to them, as you are getting to them, your life is drawing back. Because the question you be asking, it will never be answered because of the group of people you move with. You need not just walk with God. You need to walk with only God. Then, by then you ask, you receive. Then you will knock, and the door will be open. That is when you will seek, and you will surely find. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Before the end of this day, you and I will see. We shall receive. No good things from you. We shall receive it. That is charged as for prayer, and you give him a stone.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Who is that man among you when he's charged as for prayer, and we give him a little stone? None of us will do that. When our child asks for something tangible, you will never give him or her something bad in return. It is a question from the father. The father, the son or the daughter asks something from the father, that's bread. The father will never return with a stone. The reason is because he or she asks from a father. But if he or she did not ask from the father, it is not just a stone. It is not only stone. Even if he or she is asking from the right source and from the wrong source, they will not just give stone, they will give back. The meaning of this is that whatever you ask from God is not, whatever you ask that is not of God. Such people will go through some answers that is perilous. They will even give them, they will even whip them. But when you ask in God, you will receive. And what he gives to you, there will be comfort with you. There will be perseverance. There will be satisfaction. There will be peace of mind and joy. There will be upliftment and growth. Or he has to teach, and I will be given a serpent. If ye tell me evil, know how to give good gifts to children, how much more your Father in heaven, will give good things to those that ask of him. He will give them good things. He will give you good things. When you stand with him, it is only him that
says,
You shall find. You shall open. He that asks,
receive it.
And
it
don't agree.
He that see,
glory,
find it.
And it don't
he that know,
I see, shift
open. Let us
abide.
Let us pray. God, I beg you. I beg you this time. I have not asked for people. I have been a fellow woman. What
I'm
supposed to ask
him? I
have to ask him. I have
to ask him.
Jesus. Lord, we are supposed to be asking.
So
I'm asking a fellow
woman.
Instead of asking you, God, God forgive me. God forgive me. It is a sin. God, I beg you. You are the only one. And they pray to God. Instead of going to get sick for job, the person went back to the prayer mountain. You are asking for blessing. If you don't go to ask for blessing, that person will not be blessed. We are supposed to seek for
God.
We are supposed to take a step. Help my faith. To take the
poster.
To take the poster. In the name of Jesus. Lord, help my faith. Help my faith, oh God. Help my faith, oh God. To take the poster. To move all my life. The poster. That we enable you to witness the glory of your God. Lord, help me, oh God. Help me. We are going to pray. Every door I've been knocking on for a long time ago, open those doors for me. With your hand of power, open those doors. In the name of Jesus, the doors I've been knocking on, the doors I've been knocking on for a long time. Lord, with your hand of power, open those doors for me. Open those doors for me. Open those doors for me. The God of blessing, the God of
affliction,
the God of growth. In Jesus' name we are praying. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Lord, we have heard your word. It says we should ask and we shall receive. Lord, wherever we have been asking that we have misasked, or we ask at the wrong source, in the name of the Father, Lord, forgive us. Amen. You are the only one that has the power to forgive us. When we ask from you, if you give unto us, it will bring joy
along.
It will bring blessing along. It will bring watching along. It will bring
upliftment.
Whatever we have not asked, even if we receive, it might be bitterness, it might be sorrow, it might be
downcastness,
it might be disappointment. We ask for forgiveness. Whenever we have sworn at the way of you, that we didn't ask for you,
God has
given us in Jesus' name. All that we will be asking for, henceforth from you, God. So lazy. When we are supposed to take a
poster
to see what you want us to see, it's not your blessing and affliction and glory.
I'm
blessed and glory.
Let your new life
from today. Because we will
call you to
our faith,
our
faith, so that we can see the results of good things to come. Abraham took the
poster
and he was seeking, and as you are
saturating
it, and you were able to see good things, Abraham got good things that you God promised Abraham. Our belief is that to the point To follow your ways, to follow your doctrine. We beg you, O God,
Thank you for answering.
We will have joy and praise you, and all the glory returns to you. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Hallelujah.